With one of the state's most culturally diverse populations, West Lafayette has a lot of stories to tell in its more than 120-year history. A recent endowment is now collecting and archiving those stories. Joining us is director of the West Lafayette Public Library, Nick Schenkel. Nick, thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome. Thanks for having me
today. So this is a really exciting time for really the greater Lafayette area.
Yes, it is.
Talk a little bit about this new endowment and a little bit of background stories behind it.
Sure. Well, thanks to the generosity of Sonia and Dale Marjoram. They made an endowment to the Greater Lafayette Community Foundation, and the interest from that endowment is coming to the library to run the West Lafayette Public Library History and Research Center, which is a collection of materials that we've gathered over the years and that we're seeking to gather more for the community to use.
And some really neat things you have
yes.
here. You brought us this morning.
Yes.
Talk a little bit about the history and what pieces of history you guys are going to be featuring at the library.
Sure. As you indicated, West Lafayette's history goes way back in time, and we're concentrating on the entire period of West Lafayette history from the Native Americans all the way up until present. I brought with me today scrapbooks from one of our local football coaches whose family was kind enough to donate these. These go back to the late 1940s up until he ended his career. It's a fantastic look at West Lafayette High School sports during that time. An article from Better Homes and Gardens of all places talking about retaining walls in the new area of West Lafayette in the 1920s. A high school yearbook from the first high school yearbook that we can track down from West Lafayette from 1901. Of course, all the papers that have been collected from Sonia Marjoram's varied career. Cookbooks, cannot get enough cookbooks.
You certainly cannot.
A real look into the community, the diversity of the community. And we're so happy, we're now receiving papers, in fact, this became a book. We're receiving papers from Purdue students who are looking into the history of West Lafayette, whether that is individuals or parks or housing. It's just a fascinating history that our little town actually has.
So you guys already have a wide variety of things featured here, but you guys mm-hmm. are also looking for donations for people to add to the collection. Talk about that.
Very definitely. The way to tell the story of West Lafayette is to collect the information from West Lafayette residents. So we're looking for letters, for cookbooks, for publicity materials, for scrapbooks, for all kinds of materials that folks may have. They're not quite sure what to do with it. They don't want to let it go because it tells something about their history, their family's story, and tells the larger story of West Lafayette. So we're glad to take it when they're ready to give those materials up and have them in a public place. We're glad to take them in, catalog them, and make them available to the larger community.
All right. Hopefully we'll see that collection expand. Nick Schenkel
Indeed.
With the West Lafayette Public Library. Thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Come